adding and subtracting decimals. When adding and subtracting decimals, we're going to live by one rule, and that rule is that we're always going to line up the decimals. Always line up your decimals. So, let me show you what that looks like. Let's say we were asked to add 19 and 52 hundredths and add to that 5 and 371 thousandths. Okay. Right now they're not lined up, so I need to write them in vertical form. So I'm going to write them as 19.52 plus 5.371. I made sure my decimals were lined up, and there's a reason for that. And after that, I just line up all the numbers. So I don't have anything to go with the 1, so I'm just going to put a 0 there. And remember, I can add as many zeros as I want to the end of a number, a decimal number, and it doesn't change its value. Now I'm just going to add. And the only role the decimal point is going to play is that it's going to come straight down. And that's why we line them up. Other than that, you're going to add just like if they were whole numbers. So 0 plus 1 is 1. 7 plus 2 is 9. 5 plus 3 is 8. 9 plus 5 is 14. Carry the 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. So my answer, and that doesn't look very nice, so let me rewrite it. 24 and 891 thousandths. So nothing different than what I've done before. And that's it? Yeah. So let's say we wanted to add 19 and 26 and 72 thousandths. Okay, the 19 doesn't have a decimal point, so how can I make the 19 have a decimal point? Yeah, just make it 0.000. So here's 19, here's 26.072. Since the 19 doesn't have a decimal point, I'm just going to make it 0.000. Remember, adding zeros to the end of a decimal doesn't change its value. And then just add. And just drop the decimal point into place. So what do I get out of that? 45 point what? Oh, yeah, you're right. So 0 plus 2 is 2. 0 plus 7 is 7. 0, 15, carry the 1, 4. You could do that as well. It's the same thing as adding decimal 0, 0, 0.
Yeah. 19.
Okay, let's talk about dealing with different signs. So whenever we have different signs, we're going to recall the rules that we learned for adding integers. Recall adding integers. So say we wanted to add, let's show you what this looks like, 3 and 72 hundredths, and add to that negative 4 and 78 hundredths. So back when we were talking about adding integers, back to chapter 2, how do we add those numbers?
Graph them.
Well, you could graph them, that's one way to do it. Yeah. How else do we do it? We had a specific method for doing this. A negative number added to a positive number. Subtract the smaller from the largest, yeah. So if you recall, what we said is we're going to ignore the signs for a second, and we're going to take the smallest from the largest. So what's the largest?
We're sitting
ignoring the sign. Ignoring the sign, 478 is the largest. So 4.78. Take away from that the smaller number. Okay. So right now we're just ignoring signs and we're taking the smaller from the largest. So when I do that, I'm going to do that the same way as adding decimals. I'm just going to drop the decimal point and subtract. What do I get? 1.16. Then that's my answer, but I don't know the sign of that answer yet. To figure out the sign of the answer, I'm going to go back to the original problem and figure out the bigger number had what sign, a positive sign or a negative sign?
Negative.
Negative sign. So this is going to be negative then. So that's how I get that answer. Now if you think about it, that makes sense. If you have $3.62 and you owe $4.78, you're still going to owe $1.16. So let's practice this with combining like terms. Say we have negative 4.3y plus 7.8 minus 20.1y plus 14.6. Okay? What are the like terms in this expression?
The y
is on the constant, right? So here's a set of like terms, and here's another set of like terms. Okay. The problem with the y's is that they're both negative numbers. So again, go back to those rules for adding integers. How do I add two negative numbers? Add the numbers together and keep the sign. Right. So I'm going to add 4.3 and 20.1 together. Okay, regardless, so whether they're both positive or both negative, if they both have the same sign, I just add them up and keep the sign. So when I add these up, my answer is going to be what? It's going to be 24.4, and it's going to be the sign of both of the numbers, which was negative. So that's why that's negative. So when I write this out, when I combine the y's, I'm going to get negative 24.4y. Now let's add the constants. Again, this is a case where we have two positive numbers, two numbers, same signs. I'm just going to add them up, keep the positive sign. So if I add up 7.8 and add to that 14.6, what's my answer going to be there? What is it? 22.4. And it's positive because both numbers were positive. And that's it. I can't combine this anymore because they're not like terms. Let's do a couple more practice problems. Let's say that I wanted to add negative 2.13 and add to that 4.81. How would I add these two numbers? I have a negative number and a positive number. What's that?
Bigger number.
Bigger number minus a smaller number. So I'm going to take 4.81 minus 2.13. Good. So what do I get out of that?
268.
Right, so I have to borrow from the 8, so it becomes 11 minus 3 is 8, 7 minus 1 is 6, 4 minus 2 is 2. Okay, I have that answer, now I need to figure out what sign the answer is. Well, 2.13 had a negative number, a negative sign, and 4.81 had a positive sign. 4.81 is bigger, so the answer is going to be positive. Because the bigger number gets the sign. So that's how I get 268, positive. More questions about this?